Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm about to play back a Pokemon game for you here. Let me know in the comments if you like the whole video commentary idea. I gotta have some beer. Hang on. That's nice. But we're gonna play this back right now. And let me know if you guys like the video commentary or not. I don't really want to rip off Quandao Ren, Elo, whatever. That's not my intention, it's just something different. Maybe you might like it, I don't know. But here we go. So this is a guy I met on one of Elo's streams, actually. And he's going to be leading off with a Heatran, it looks like. And I'm going to be leading off with my Dragonite. This is that dragon team you guys have seen quite a bit in my videos lately. And truthfully, I don't really like OU, but, you know, I figured I'll get several battles with this team because it is a good team. And he's going to lead off, looks like a Scarfed Heatran, or maybe it's just an offensive Heatran. I'm not earning max speed on this Dragonite, so I don't know. But I'm not going to over-predict. Heatran's pretty dangerous. I'm just going to go for the Earthquake. I know I can live that Dragon Pulse, even if it's like specs, because I have the multi-skill. And I kill him off with Earthquake. He goes out into Gengar, and Gengar is kind of an asshole. Especially this generation with Disable and stuff, so I go out into Vaporeon because really that's the only thing that can really take a special hit from this thing. All my other stuff isn't really too keen on taking a Shadow Ball or what have you, or even getting Disabled. I'm going to Protect to see if he's packing the Thunderbolt. He is packing the Thunderbolt. I do not like that, so I'm going to have to roar him out. I didn't want to wish because I didn't know how much this would do. Probably around half, I was guessing, but I didn't want to risk it, you know, in case he got a crit or something of that sort. Then I'd just be in a hole, like, dead without a sub. So, I roar him out, roar him into the, like, worst possible thing I could have roared him into, Breloom. And Breloom is going to proceed to do what Breloom's do. They spore, they set up subs, and they act like dicks. But I'm going to predict him to go for sub and not spore, predicting me to switch out. I'm going to roar him out of there, get your ass out of there, son, and roar him back into Gengar. So it's just like, ah, bad luck with these roars. I really wish I could get, like, you know, a ground type or something I actually hurt or wish on in here. But I don't. So in comes Gengar again. I am going to predict him not to sub. I'm going to predict him to attack. So I'm going to go out to Haxorus here. Either way, I have Mold Breaker. I can break his sub. I can take a hit. Whatever he wants to do. And luckily for me, he does go for the T-Bolt. So that is awesome. I evade him behind a sub, which would have sucked. And this is a banded Haxorus. So I know I can take a Shadow Ball hit if it wants to go for it. I do have the Mold Breaker. And I'm going to just Earthquake it. And Earthquake is just going to decimate it. I barely live there with 20 HP, so I got pretty lucky. But, going to take it out with the Earthquake. Moldbreaker Haxorus is so cool. I love Haxorus. It's badass. Anywho, he's going to go into his Mind Shell now, or Mean Shell, whatever you want to call it. Obvious Fake Out is obvious, like super obvious. So I'm going to go out into Cresselia. Cresselia walls whatever he wants to do. If he wants to U-turn, whatever, it doesn't matter. Cresselia is a beast. Cresselia is a beast. Don't see why this thing's RU, honestly. Anyway, after leftovers, that fake out does nothing. This U-turn, not too concerned about it. It'll hurt, but it won't hurt enough to do anything. Look at that. It does about a fourth after the fake out and whatnot. So he's going to go back and switch into, what does he go into? This is kind of an old game, I don't really remember. Goes into Big Mudkip, his Swampert. Probably predicting a Thunder Wave. I just go for the Psychic because I want damage on whatever. Unfortunately for me, this Swampert looks to be specially defensive, and that is quite the dilemma here. But since I know it's specially defensive now, I know I could probably go out into a Haxorus knowing he wants to set up Rocks, because Rocks would kill my Haxorus upon re-entry, so I might as well switch into it. That prediction pays off immensely because he does go for the Rocks, which allows me to get a free hit on him because there's no way he's going to be faster. And honestly, since he's specially defensive, I'm expecting this Bandit Outrage to just absolutely maim him. And I'm just going to go for it, you know, not going to overpredict or anything like that. I'm just going to go for the highest damage move I have. And it almost takes it out. Oh, almost takes it out. I would have killed if that would have killed it. That doesn't make sense. But he takes me out with an Earth Power. But it's okay because Haxorus just decimated him right there. Anyway, I'm going to go out into Concubine now, my Conkeldurr. And this is not the usual bulk up set, the bulk up Conkeldurr. This is actually a sub-punching Conkeldurr, which totally catches people off guard. And if Gliscor is out of the way, this thing will wreck shop. So I'm going to go for a sub right here. And knowing that Earth Power won't kill me, my special defense is weaker than my physical defense, so kind of sucks. Gonna take a little more from that than I like. But Swampert really doesn't invest much in either attack, so I'm gonna hit him with a Mach Punch here. This is Iron Fist boosted, which I realize isn't released, so sorry, don't hate on me, but I just wanted something that would go better with Substitute, and it's better than Guts, so yeah. Iron Fist boosts and Mach Punch takes it out. He sends in Breloom here. I don't know why. It can't really do much. He probably should have sent in, like, Mind Shout, a Fake Out, and then, like, sent in Fortress to take the Focus Punch and then broke the sub, but he didn't. He's going to go for a sub of his own. Don't really know why. It's just, like, wasting turns, it looks like, wasting time, because there's no way he's going to get out of the situation in a good way. I mean, especially now, if I wanted to, I probably could just kill him with Mach Punch from here because Breloom is very non-defensive. But instead, I'm just going to go for the safe Focus Punch in case he wants to switch. I want to hit something hard on the switch or whatever. And I do hit it with Focus Punch, and that is way, way, way too much overkill. Iron Fist boosted Focus Punch will destroy anything that it hits, bar Gliscor. So his Breloom goes down, and now I'm sitting pretty good here. There's not much. I think he only has a Mind Shell and a Fortress left, so he might have something else. I don't remember too clearly, but he's going to fake me out. Not going to do too much. Actually, it's going to do a lot because it's a crit, so that kind of sucks, but I get some return hacks here for that crit, which is going to really suck. I'm going to hit him with a Mach Punch, knowing he's going to go for that high jump kick, and luckily for me, he misses his high jump kick. And at that range, thanks to me doing or going for a Mach Punch, it's gonna kill him. So, don't know if that actually that definitely made up for the crit he got on me, but I don't know if that was the kind of hacks he wanted right there. Still, I don't think it really mattered because I have my D Knight with extreme speed still, and I've got something. I got Cresselia still to take on Mind Shell, so it's not really a big deal. And he goes into Fortress. Fortress really can't do much. This is a crit Gyro Ball. It doesn't even break my sub because I'm so slow. So, just salt in the wound, really. And I'm gonna Focus Punch here. He does have Sturdy, so he can survive no matter what. And then he's gonna hit me with a Payback. Not really sure why it is resisted. I guess he just wants to save PP on Gyro Ball for whatever reason. He's really got no chance though here against this because, I mean, look at that. That's a physically defensive Fortress and it's a 2-hit KO clean, no problem. And right here, I predict him to like, I don't know what I predicted him to do. I think I predicted him to go into something else or whatever. I'm not sure. Well, I predicted his sub to break, or his attack to break my sub, or something like that. I don't even know. But, Mach Punch isn't gonna do much, but Payback's not gonna do much either. I see I have just enough, left for sub. I saw that even his crit Gyro Ball didn't break my sub before, so I'm going to go for a sub now, and, with 14 HP left, he's gonna Gyro Ball. It's not gonna take out my sub. And I'm going to go for a Focus Punch here. And I'm not sure if that's for the win or not. but I know that he doesn't have much left if it's not for the win. So, yeah, waiting for all these astroturn effects here. And, gotta go for the focus punch. Gyro Ball is not even gonna break my sub, I don't think. It might, I'm not sure. No, it doesn't. So I get a focus punch off, still behind the sub here. This just goes to show the power of focus punch Conkeldurr. Like, it's an absolute beast. I mean, the bulk up set is more practical. Yeah, that was the last one. The bulk up set's more practical, but focus punch always catches people by surprise. Surprise? Anyway, let me know if you guys enjoyed the video commentary thing. If you did, please leave a like rating and subscribe, comment, do all that good stuff. And I will see you later. Bye.